Good afternoon, friends. I'm Sudhakar Shanbhag, Head of Investments at Kotak Life Insurance. The Interim Union Budget 2019 was important since it was in the background of upcoming general elections in May 2019 and the stress in rural and farm sectors. The key proposals announced during the budget were Prime Minister's Kisan Samman Yojana, which will provide 6,000 rupees direct benefit transfers to farmers who have small land holdings, which will cost about 75,000 crores. The second one being Prime Minister's Shrama Manadhan Yojana, which will provide pension of rupees 3,000 to workers from the unorganized sector while they contribute a small amount during their working life. The third being the nil tax up to a total taxable income of rupees 5 lakhs in the form of rebate. With these announcements, the Finance Minister has addressed the farm and rural sector as well as the large unorganized and middle class segments in the country. These measures will further stimulate the consumption side of the economy. Fiscal deficit at 3.4% is a deviation from the FRBM projected path, though is flat over FY19's 3.4%, which had shortfall in GST collections and non-tax revenues. Nominal GDP growth for FY20 is estimated at 11.5% compared to 12.2% for FY19. Assumptions around tax revenue growth of 15% would be possible with a higher tax base and appropriate implementations. Non-tax revenues and divestment target seem achievable. Total expenditure growth has been estimated at 13.3%, which looks reasonable. Capital expenditure increase is, however, only 6.2%, which could have been higher to support sustained growth. The gross and net market borrowing figures of about 7 lakh crores and 4.7 lakh crores, including buybacks, is a bit higher compared to FY19 and may negate the lower inflation-related benefit we could have seen in bond yields. We will have to be prepared to brace with volatility on this account. The equity markets will now move back its focus on earnings, which are expected to be in mid-teens for FY20 and FY21, and will have to gauge the impact of flows in domestic markets, which have been good over the last couple of years, and see whether there will be positive inflows from FIIs with a dovish Fed. With all market events have been analyzed and understood, it is recommended that we stick to our respective asset allocation to meet our desired goals. The more money which the finance minister has put into our pockets should be used to focus on families' protection and long-term saving needs. Thank you for listening in, and happy saving and investing.